sin and repentance. Allah informs us in the Holy Quran, Nabbi ibadi anni ana al-ghafur al-rahim. Inform my servants, O Prophet Muhammad. Announce to all the people, anni ana al-ghafur al-rahim, that I am the most forgiving, the most merciful. Wa anna adhabi, but my punishment, huwa al-adhabu al-alim, is a severe punishment. In several verses of the Holy Quran, Allah refers to himself as the most forgiving, the oft forgiving, most merciful. And Allah time and again in the Holy Quran encourages people to repent to him. He says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, O ye who believe, tubu ila Allah, seek forgiveness from Allah, repent to Allah, tawbatan nasuha, true repentance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa man lam yatub fa ulaika humu dhalimun. In this verse, Allah divides people into two categories. He says there are those that ask repentance and those who are unjust, those who are transgressors. مَنْ لَمْ يَتُبْ, he that does not ask Allah to forgive him, فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ, those are the transgressors. We need to ask Allah to forgive us time and again, every day, because we sin every day. The Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, all the children of Adam, meaning the entire mankind, خَطَّاؤُونَ, they all make mistakes. وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّائِينَ, and the best of those that make mistakes, التَّوَّابِينَ, those that ask Allah to forgive them. However, coming to the question, is there some sins that we may consider to be minor and other sins that we consider to be major? Of course, some sins are bigger than other sins, but even the smaller sins, when they accumulate, they cause the heart to harden. When the heart is hard, we lose our sense of shame. We start with the minor sins and eventually we progress to the major sins. Some people may say, I do not see anything wrong with shaking hands with women, for example, or hugging a woman, or staring at a woman. After all, that's not such a sin. I've not done anything with her. I've not touched her. I simply looked at her. But everything has a beginning. Looking is only the beginning. Who knows where this is going to drive in the future? And what hardness, the coarseness that this can cause to the heart. We need to keep our hearts clean. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, to a believer, his sins are like a mountain. A believer, when he thinks about his sins, he is so overwhelmed. He thinks he is sitting at the foot of a mountain, and this mountain is going to collapse on him and destroy him any time. When a believer thinks about the wrong things that he has done, he thinks, these things will be my demise. This is going to fall on me. This is going to kill me. He worries about his sins. But for a person who has no faith, the sins are as insignificant as a fly that sits on his nose. What does he do? He pays it no attention, just one gesture and it's gone. We need to pay particular attention. Do not look at the size of the sin. Look at the size of the one you have disobeyed. It's not the size of the sin. Look at how great the Almighty God is. Even to disobey him in a minor way, you do not want to do that. You want to please God all the time. So a lot of people today have neglected what is called in Islam tawbah or repentance because they think what they commit are not actually major sins, they are minor sins. But I want to tell you, it's the minor sins that, you know, harden the heart. And then you said, are there conditions that we need to follow in order for us to repent? Or do we just repent? There is a difference in Islam between asking for forgiveness and repenting. When I ask for forgiveness, it's just a word. Please forgive me. But there is still a question, have I repented in my heart? I need to repent and then ask for forgiveness. Repentance is something much bigger than asking for forgiveness. So if repentance is that big, then it needs conditions, of course, things that we need to follow. What must we follow? The Muslim scholars have taught us, using the Quran and using the tradition of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that there are certain conditions that we need to follow before we can repent. Firstly, they say, إِقْلَاعَ عَنِ الذَّنْبِ. You need to stay away from that particular sin. The moment you realize it's a sin, and you're not supposed to do it, you need to stop. You cannot say, I realize it's sinful, but let me finish it first and then I'll repent after that. The condition is that you need to stop what you are doing immediately. I want to give an example of the companions of the Messenger Muhammad, may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, before alcohol was forbidden in Islam. Before the prohibition of alcohol, Muslims used to drink in the time of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. At first, the prohibition was, when you are drunk, do not go for prayers, which means you need to keep sober between prayers. After you pray, you could drink, and then when you are sober,